divers, Alec, Peirce, Scuba with tech tips. Some ideas that might make your diving a little easier, even more enjoyable, even maybe a bit safer. I hope that these tech tips, you're learning something from them. I've been diving a very long time, soon be 60 years of scuba diving. I know, scares me too. And the point is that I've made a lot of mistakes. That many years of scuba diving, you make a lot of mistakes. I make lots of mistakes, but I learn from them. So I picked up a lot of ideas, and some of the ideas I found have worked really well for me and for other divers, maybe for you too. Judging from the comments, you can read the comments on the underneath each of the these YouTube episodes. You can see that there's other divers who have shared ideas with me, and they've also asked me. So here's a good point. If you have a problem, maybe a problem with a BC or a regulator or something's bugging you, for God's sakes, send me a comment. Pick one of my playlists and just go down and say, hey, Alan, what would you do in this case? And maybe I have an idea that might help. At least it might make you think of something else. So that's the way it works. Now, what I want to spend a few minutes on today is, in fact, a topic suggested by viewers, right, Kevin? Not readers. he asked me to say something about ankle weights. I'd spoken about weight belts earlier and about weight integrated BCs, and all that's pretty simple stuff. I had a couple of ideas of what you could do to make the integrated weight belt system maybe a little easier to work with. But this particular viewer wanted me to talk about ankle weights, and I can do that. I've used ankle weights for a long, long time. In fact, the first ankle weights I used were homemade, because you couldn't go and buy ankle weights. You go into your local dive store and say, I want to buy ankle weights. What? So the first ankle weights I made, they were simply 1 pound lead weights strapped to my leg. And I found they were pretty handy at that time for that particular purpose, which I forget at the moment. But now you can buy ankle weights. You can actually go and buy ankle weights that go on your ankles. Am I making sense here? And they have weights, you see. So first of all, let's talk about why you might want to have ankle weights. Weights that fasten around your ankle. There's a couple of reasons. And having trained divers for a long, long time, 75, so 40 years, I've seen lots of divers in different situations, and I have an idea who benefits from ankle weights, why they benefit, and so on. It's very simple. In order to maintain a proper attitude underwater, and I'm not talking about cheerful or depressed. By attitude, I mean your angle in the water, head down, foot down, and your attitude, your angle in the water as you're swimming along. And that can change. If you're diving on a quiet, shallow reef, or if you're diving in a stiff current or in a ship, you see though that angle, what you want might change. You may or may not benefit from ankle weights. I've discovered over the years that for some reason, ladies benefit from ankle weights. Now, it might be that maybe their legs aren't quite as strong, although don't misinterpret that. Lots of ladies I know can outdive me easily. But often, ladies, their leg muscles are not like a man's muscles designed to be, extra strong. So they sometimes, maybe that's the reason. Or I'm just not exactly sure. Maybe it's their body shape, which I think is wonderful, but it's different than a man's, which I think is great too. But for some reason, ladies seem to benefit from ankle weights, okay? Another reason you might use ankle weights is if you're wearing a dry suit. Now, if you have no experience with dry suits and you've never dived in cold water, just skip a minute and a half of this. But if you are wearing a dry suit, dry suits by their very nature have air in the legs and often in the boot. Air goes up. You understand, air goes up, right? So that means that your leg and your boot are pulled up, pushed up, whichever. And in order to counteract that, sometimes an ankle weight can be very beneficial. Keep your leg down where it belongs. So the use of an ankle weight is something that's optional. You don't have to wear them. If you try an ankle weight and it's beneficial, then use it during things. I know there are some agencies and diving and dive instructors who suggest that you shouldn't need ankle weights. And that you don't need ankle weights because if you're in good physical condition and you're diving, you know, using proper skills or practice proper skills, but you don't need ankle weights. Well, that's not a bad philosophy. Of course, I don't disagree with that, but I do happen to know that everybody's different. So if you happen to be 5'5" and weigh 140 pounds, as opposed to Kevin, who is 6'2" and weighs 300 pounds, you see, things are different for each. Things are different. The amount of wetsuit and dry suit that Kevin needs compared to this gentleman, whoever it is, can be a lot different. So he's going to have to rearrange his weight, rearrange his equipment, and do all kinds of different things so he can dive safely and comfortably. It's important to be comfortable, or what's the point? So to suggest that every diver dives the same, fins the same physical condition, same weights and so on. No, it just doesn't wash. It'd be nice if we all had identical driving skills on the highway, but we don't. So there are some differences. That's not a good analogy, but let's carry on. So ankle weights can be beneficial. Okay, try them. What to do if you're having difficulties keeping your legs down, keeping your fins under the water, keeping your attitude, head down or foot down, whatever it is you're trying to. If you're having difficulty with that, maybe ankle weights are the answer. Okay, here's what you can do. Ankle weights. The first ankle weights, my first ankle weights, as I mentioned, were a strap with a weight on it. And they still make weights a bit like that. They now use a better strap. This is long, too long. You shorten it, of course, but this is a simple Fastex type clip. And you snap it together. And on this, I don't have any. Unfortunately, I looked around the dive store and we have no ankle weights. We sold them out. We sell them a lot, actually, to synchronized swimmers. Helps them keep their attitude right in the water, which is vertical, by the way, not like us. And the weights that go on this strap are half-pound chiclets. They're called chiclets. They're called chiclets because they look like chiclets. They're not white necessarily, look like big chiclets or 1/2 pound of lead with a plastic coating. We always use plastic coated weights, as you know. So you put on one of those, 1/2 pound, 2, 1 pound, 3, 1.5 pounds, simple math, huh? And so you put on different amounts of the chiclets, make the strap to the size of your ankle, put it around your ankle, and you have an ankle weight. I suggest one in each ankle. It's good to be balanced so you don't swim at an angle like this. So this is a very, very simple type of ankle weight, works really, really well. Another type of ankle weight, which is came from the same idea, is this one. Now, this is interesting because this particular ankle weight uses a rubber-lined neoprene bag. You can see it here. And it also has Fastex straps on it. And this bag is filled with lead shot. So this weighs 1 pound. 1 pound, you see? And you see the same thing. You snap this around your ankle, and it's stretchy, so it's tight on your ankle, and it stays on your ankle, so you have 1 pound on each ankle. You don't need much in ankle weights in terms of ankle. You don't put 6 pounds on your legs, for sure. So 1 pound makes a big difference. You'd be amazed how much 1 pound on your ankles difference it makes. Here's another newer and very, very nice ankle weight as well. This is a tube. Not like the last one, but it's a little nicer shape. It's tube, has a rubber liner in there, so the lead doesn't leak, you don't get lead in the water. And this tube, you see it's stretchy, see that? And so it has, again, Fastex fasteners held on with good strong metal clips, and you put this around, you stretch it around your ankle, snap it shut, and there's your hand. Now these ones weigh about 1.5 pounds, so altogether, 1.5 pounds on each ankle, you'd have about 3 pounds. And again, this is all you need. You don't need very much. Just 1 pound of ankle weights on each ankle makes a big, big difference in your ability to keep your feet where they belong. An interesting thing I've noticed over the years is people will say, well, if I put 3 pounds on my ankles, I can take 3 pounds off my weight belt. It doesn't seem to work that way. I don't know why that is. It makes sense, but it doesn't work. Strangely enough, if you take 3 pounds off your weight belt, put on ankle weights, you'll find you're probably going to be too light. I don't know exactly why that is. It may have something to do with the fact your legs are moving all the time. I'm not exactly sure what that is. Anyway, you snap this around your ankle, on each ankle, and off you go and give it a try. For many, many people, it helps. Once you put on a wetsuit, certainly if you're in cold water, and it's a 7 millimeter, 1/4 inch wetsuit, and then you put on wetsuit boots, which are also made of foam neoprene, they are both very buoyant. You know that wetsuits and wetsuit boots are very, very buoyant. So the wetsuit and wetsuit boots tend to make you very buoyant. Hence, ankle weights can help. And even more so with the dry suit, as I mentioned. There are neoprene dry suits, even crushed neoprene dry suits have some buoyancy, but all dry suits have buoyancy because of the air inside. So the ankle weights can help a great deal. So I suggest you give them a try. They're not expensive. You probably get to ankle weights, a set of ankle weights for $20 or $30 easily. They come in different colors and they snap around your ankles. The other small benefit that you get with the ankle weights when wearing a dry suit, more with a dry suit than a wetsuit, of course, is that there's a tendency, and you will learn this either in a dry suit course or by experience, good or bad, that in a dry suit, if your head goes down and your feet go up, feet up here, air tends to move through the dry suit into your legs and into your feet. So you can get air in the legs and feet. Now you get air in the legs, and certainly if you get air into the feet, into the foot pocket, sometimes you'll find you can't get that air out. You can't get your feet back down, and so you end up vertical, head down. Not a good situation to be in. These ankle weights not only give you a bit of weight on your feet, on your ankles, but they actually, because they're usually fairly snug around the ankle, will also help to stop air movement into your feet. that can be beneficial as well. A little aside, I've seen people use these ankle weights for other purposes as well. So if you're a diver and you're trying to keep in shape and you walk or jog every day, put ankle weights on. Yeah, it can make a difference. Boy, you'll see your leg muscles grow. I've seen people with them on their arms and on their knees and so on. So they're actually a pretty good investment. Might be a big help while you're, for your diving. It can help in other areas as well. So now I hope that this has answered some of the question of the reader, the viewer who asked about ankle weights. Some ideas in there anyway. If possible, I would go to your local dive store and see if they have some ankle weights or make something up yourself. Give it a try. Okay? If you say, hey, wow, this is great. Really, really good. Get a set. Not expensive, and it can make your diving a lot more fun. I hope that helped a little bit. Keep the comments coming. I love them, and I'll see you soon in another Alec Peirce Tech Tips. Bye-bye.